What is this life full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. No time to see in broad daylight streams full of stars like skies at night. People come and people go. Everyday life, it absorbs us. It is so usual to see a boy wandering about the streets with nothing to give and nothing to take, just yearning for compassion and love. A boy who wants to reach his goals but seems lost. People also say that children are the country's future, but sadly most of them fail to realize that by being aware of others and developing respect for them, we enrich lives by making them happier and making our lives more content.
Children are the weapon of development. As it is rightly said, the future of any country depends on its children. So it is of paramount importance that we safeguard their innocence and protect their childhood.
Children may appear lost, but their dreams never die. Dreams are perpetual.
If you ever try looking into their eyes, there are a million things which they're trying to convey. Their eyes are full of expectations, hope, and desire. Expectations from the cream of the society. Hope to move a step further and desire to fulfill their dreams. In the last 1 month, we tried our level best to help them move a bit further and enjoy their life with us, along with us at Aashansh.
While working with the kids, it is very important to understand and comprehend the background they're coming from. So we had to plan some activities apt for them. So keeping this in mind, we organized a mela called Dazzaro. We already tried to put things in place, but once into the event, the kids took complete charge of it. It is also very significant to see the kind of positives that come across while organizing these kind of events for children. One would be the kind of confidence that builds into them after being motivated by the community members and the elders. The second, in my opinion, was the sense of participation into them, which exemplifies their emotion to give back to the society.
In the mela, we had organized certain games and the children were like totally responsible to take care of those games. They were taking care of the props, they greeted all the people who were coming. It was open to the whole public. It was a mode of medium for them to connect to the community. And it was like really, really very nice to look to see them mingling with each other, helping each other out. And at the end of the day, it was a responsibility that we put on their shoulders, and they carried out really very well and made us really very proud.
Mela helped the others to realize that these kids are no different from any other normal kids. That even though after being street kids, these kids can do what any other kid can. In fact, even more than that.
And then came the Christmas party. It was ultimate.
We did a lot of decorations. We decorated the entire room.
And let me tell you a secret. I was Santa. When I first saw so many children around me, hugging me, pulling my costume, pulling my beard, my God.
And we also organized the shadow skit for them, which talks about real and ideal self. And the most cherished moment was for me, ki they actually, whatever I wanted to explain during the shadow skit, the topic, the story, they totally understood the concept and the moral of the story.
For Shining Stars, which was organized by Pragati Foundation, obviously it was dance, so I was training dance. It was taken as a more like a therapeutic measure for the kids because it provided them with an outlet for the energies that could have gone destructive otherwise. Secondly, what I would like to say is that there were a lot of changes seen coming across. They had team spirit in them. They were able to face their stage fears. They also interacted so much, and they had the team spirit of cheering everyone in the environment. While the performances, even though we did not win, they were encouraging the winners. They were cheering for them, which was a very good thing, in my opinion.
On the day of the competition, I saw the kids performing so confidently on the stage, and there were some kids who were very scared to perform. One day before, they came and told me like, we are very scared to perform, but on the day of the competition, they were very confident, and I'm happy that teaching them dance, making them confidence, this was a thing I did for them. And also they were cheering for other kids, even though we didn't win the competition, but they were cheering for other kids so well that, you know, I felt very, very nice looking at such values the kids have in them.
Teaching the kids was a fantastic experience. The kids picked up whatever was taught to them really fast. I taught them English grammar. I taught them about the consonants and the vowels. The kids interacted with me really well. Also, they picked up stuff very fast. And you know, they were eager to learn. They had doubts, which I cleared out.
When I think about science, I have very bad memories relating science because I hated that subject to the core. But now I have many good memories relating science, all because of these kids. These kids were so good. They gelled with me so well while teaching. They cooperated with me very nicely. I taught them parts of the plant, which was the basic of science. And I didn't need to, you know, teach them, like force them to learn, because they had already know about all this before, because they had gone for an agricultural trip recently, sometime back.
Oh, कोई अच्छा कंपनी में अच्छा कोई जॉब मिले तो उसका बहुत भी खड़ा हो जावे. ये क्या आपके ऊपर डिपेंड है. आप जितना उसको इंस्टीट्यूट में ट्रेनिंग करेंगे तो उसके सर जिस जो उसका ब्रेन माइंडेड है वो होशियार है, लेकिन उसको क्या कोई टेक्निक दे ला आदमी की एक पढ़ाई करके उसका बन का जो खानदान का नाम है जो रोशन होना चाहिए.
वो तो बोल रहा है मैं इंजीनियर होएगा, मेहनत करेगा तो हो सकता है, वो उसके ऊपर है करने का.
One of the saddest things for a human being to do is to live a life of luxury without contributing to the happiness of those who are less fortunate than him. I believe that right education is the most important factor that can bring about a change, not only in their lives, but also in country's future. That is what inspired me. I founded Aashansh in June 2006 with with an objective of supporting street children with their school studies.
We are Aashansh.